Hey folks, Brad Sutliff here for another chemical engineering concept video. Today we're going to talk about steam boiler systems, process flow diagrams, and material balances. In addition to that, we're going to take a walk out in the field and see what all this stuff looks like in real life for our small batch processing facility here in Lock Haven, Pennsylvania. Start with the process flow diagram for the boiler system, which I have drawn up here on the whiteboard in our conference room. It all starts with the feed water. We basically get city water from the city of Lock Haven. Goes through a water softener system. We're not going to talk about a lot of these components in detail. You could research them at your leisure. But the purpose of a water softener is to substitute any of the heavier ions that come in with the city water, such as magnesium and calcium, which cause scaling issues in boilers, and replace them with softened sodium ions. This actually goes through a regeneration purge cycle with a salt brine solution, which displaces these ions and then moves the softened water through. So from there, the softened water goes into what's called a deaerator, and we have what's called a spray-type deaerator, where effectively the water comes into this tray-type thing, which drops down into what looks like a bucket and is sparged with steam. The purpose of that is to heat up the water coming in to drive off any dissolved oxygen and carbon dioxide, which cause corrosion issues in boilers through the vent. And we'll get back around to the steam purge later. From there, the feed water goes into a feed water pump, which gets pumped into the boiler for boiling and steam generation. In addition to that, we have two other smaller liquid streams. Boilers require chemical treatment to prevent corrosion, scaling, and other problems. We have two. We have a small sulfite solution drum that we have with a small metering pump. That sulfite solution gets injected into the deaerator, and the sulfite scavenges any remaining oxygen that the deaeration process doesn't eliminate. And we have another drum with a cocktail of various ingredients that prevent corrosion, scaling, other boiler issues, also pH adjustment, as there's a little bit of caustic in it. They get fed into the feed water, which also goes into the boiler, and keeps the boiler healthy. Well, from there, water gets boiled, and we have steam generation. And in our plant, steam goes two main places. We have one stream, which purges the deaerator, causes contact through this little scrubber pot system to drive off the dissolved oxygen and carbon dioxide. And we also have steam that goes to all the other major areas in the plant. And the steam we produce in our boiler is 80 PSIG saturated steam. After going through various heating uses, it gets condensed into liquid water again and pumped, transferred back to the boiler system or dumped to drain. So we have some streams that are return condensate that go all the way back through the plant into the boiler system along with the feed water into the deaerator. And then we have some streams which are simply dump right to the drain. In addition to condensate, there's two other streams that get dumped to the drain. We have what's called blowdown, and the purpose of that is to balance the treatment chemicals to make sure they don't build up in the boiler and you keep the proper balance for the concentrations that are needed. We have a daily 30 to 60 second sediment blowdown where we purge the water out and any dirt that may be collecting in the mud drum, as we call it. We also have a small amount of treatment chemicals that come out with it. We also have a surface blowdown, which is a very small half-inch line, continuous flow. The main purpose of this is to balance the treatment chemical concentration in the boiler to make sure we don't have an excess and we don't have too much. So this takes a little bit of trial and error to get that. But if you sample and analyze for your treatment chemicals, you could figure out quite easily how to balance it. So that pretty much goes over all the liquid streams. Now let's talk about the combustion side. Very simple. We get natural gas from our utility company, which happens to be UGI. We also get combustion air, which comes right in from the atmosphere with a blower. Those two get mixed in the firebox, and obviously there's a burner in there, creating the flame and the heat. That heat passes over the tubes of our water tube boiler, and then the liquid that's contained in the mud drum and part of the steam drum gets boiled, giving off a steam, as we already discussed. Then the combustion gases come out the boiler stack in the roof of the boiler room where we have some excess air, carbon dioxide, maybe some carbon monoxide, and water vapor from the combustion reaction. And we could spend days and weeks talking about boiler efficiency, combustion efficiency, so on and so forth, but we're just here to give you a general idea of what's going on. So now that we've gone over that, let's go take a walk out in the field and see the boiler system in real life. So here we are in the boiler room. So you can kind of put a visual to the diagram that we just reviewed. Right here is the plant boiler. This is a water tube style boiler. And we're going to go ahead and kind of walk through the different components of the system that'll follow right along with the process flow diagram. Here's your very first input stream, which is the actual feed water that goes to the boiler deaerator. This is a small water softener system, actually kind of similar that you might find in a home. Basically, city water from the city of Lockhaven comes in, and it goes through the softener system, and the higher metals exchange with sodium ions to soften the water, and from there it goes to the actual deaerator. So here is the deaerator for the boiler, and if you look up here and we zoom in, that is the control valve that regulates the flow of the feed water in. Feed water goes into the top of the deaerator and down through a little scrubber column. Steam contacts the feed water and helps to evacuate all the oxygen. And from there, feed water goes to the feed water pump. Feed water pump trigger on and off as the boiler calls for water. From there, the transfer line progresses up through the boiler room, down through a series of check valves to prevent backflow, and then finally up into the boiler steam drum. From there, water gets heated, enters into steam, exits through main steam header, various different areas of the plant. Here's two of our smaller input streams for the boiler system, which are the treatment chemicals. We have two. The first one here is a sulfite powder, and the purpose of the sulfite powder is to help tie up and chemically consume any of the oxygen that doesn't get driven off by the deaerator system. So that slowly gets fed and dosed directly into the deaerator and gets carried over with the boiler feed water. Next treatment chemical we have is kind of a all-in-one cocktail for boiler treatment with a corrosion inhibitor, anti-scaling agent, and all kinds of other good stuff. Get these from various manufacturers that make water treatment chemicals. From here, it gets dosed from the makeup drum up and directly into the boiler feed water line on its way into the boiler. So as we continue on our path of the water, which goes from feed water to steam out to plant distribution, we have two situations then. One, for example, like we have on this wastewater tank, is steam goes into the heating coil to keep the wastewater warm in the wintertime. But in this particular case, we dump it right to the drain and it goes to wastewater. So some of the water that gets converted into steam ends up just going right down the drain. Again, another situation, sometimes the steam gets condensed through various heating processes and then collected. Like in this example here, where the steam condensate gets collected into a small tank. And from here, the tank actually gets pumped back into a piping distribution series that goes right back into the deaerator. So we have some steam that gets wasted after it turns to condensate. We have some steam that's collected as condensate and returned in a recycle loop right back in the boiler system. We also have two very small waste streams from the boiler that's required. So chemicals and also conductivity, creating elements doesn't get collected into the boiler system. We have what we call a surface blow down, which has a small valve that's continuously cracked to bleed just a little bit of water out of the boiler and into our blowdown drum, straight down to the drain. And then once a day, for about 30 to 60 seconds, to remove any sediment that's collected on the bottom mud drum of the boiler, we open our blowdown valves, blow out down for about 30 seconds to a minute, we evacuate any buildup sediment in the bottom, which also goes right straight down the drain. So that concludes the walk down of the water side of the boiler. Now let's look at the combustion side of the boiler. So we have natural gas from the utility company that comes into the boiler room. It goes through a series of pressure reducing regulators to drop the pressure. So the pressure of the natural gas coming into the boiler is only about 6 psi. From there it goes through a series of safety valves which shut and kill fuel to the boiler in case any issues occur. From there, the natural gas goes through a control valve, which regulates the flow of natural gas into the boiler for heating demand requirements. And in this particular case right here, we have very low demand as we're on the minimum setting and lowest feed pressure. And from there, the natural gas goes into the boiler, into the actual combustion chamber, we have a nice viewing window of where it gets heated and reacts with the oxygen in the air. We have a basic natural gas oxygen combustion reaction which provides the heat, which then heats the tubes of the water tube boiler. So the tubes actually extend kind of in this shape right here from top to bottom. If you look up a water tube boiler, you'll see various examples. Lower drum, they call the mud drum, which we talked about, where the sediment collects and gets blown out. And then as the tubes get heated by the natural gas, then boils up into the steam drum, and steam comes off the top into the steam distribution header, which we saw in our water sidewalk. So now we're standing on the very top of the boiler, where it's quite warm. The air for the combustion reaction comes in through a combustion fan. There's a little arm mechanism on it for the combustion control that actually regulates the flow of air in and out instead of damper. From there, it reacts with natural gas, the combustion reaction for heat, and after it passes over the tubes, it goes out the ceiling in the boiler stack. Well, that concludes the field walk through the boiler system, both the water and combustion side. I hope you all enjoyed the video and maybe learned a little something new today. Thanks again.
Let's have one last look at that raging inferno.